Okay, so what we want to do here in this video is we're going to look at some more cranial nerves and arteries of the head. Primarily, we're going to look at the mandibular and maxillary branches of the trigeminal nerve, which is cranial nerve 5. We reflect the mandible like this. We can see the mandibular nerve and its branches coming out. We have this branch here, which is going to loop around this retroarticular process. And then we see it coming up here. And it's going to be coursing with the superficial temporal artery. This is the auriculotemporal nerve. Okay. And then the next branch coming off is this small branch here. And this is going to be the myelohyoid nerve, and we can see it again if we come here between the digastric muscle and the myelohyoideus muscle here. We see this artery, which is the sublingual branch of the facial artery, and running with that here is that myelohyoideus nerve, which is going to innervate the myelohyoid muscle. Okay. Our next branch here we see is going with an artery of the same name into the mandibular foramen. So this is going to be the inferior alveolar nerve. Inferior alveolar nerve is going to innervate all the teeth in the lower arcade. Okay, remember it also gives off the mental branch, which is going to do sensory from the lower lip and gum. Okay, so remember primarily the trigeminal nerve is going to be sensory from the head, except for those branches that go to the muscles of mastication. Our most rostral of these branches, this here is the lingual branch, and we can see that lingual branch. So here's that lingual branch coming down right here, and that is going to bring sensory from the tongue, except for taste, at least as far as the mandibular nerve is concerned. There is a branch of the facial nerve, however, in this called the chordae tympani, which joins this mandibular nerve up here near the tympanic bulla. So that portion of the facial nerve then is going to be the sensory for taste from the rostral two-thirds of the tongue. Okay. Here we've got a nice dissection from this medial aspect of these nerves once again. So here the more rostral one is that lingual branch. We then can see the inferior alveolar going into the mandibular foramen right there. And then this more caudal one here is going to be the myelohyoid nerve. And then we can see right here the auriculotemporal nerve. Okay? So those are branches of the mandibular nerve. So we have the external carotid artery here coming in, and it's going to terminate as the superficial temporal in the maxillary artery. Maxillary artery comes around here, gives off a branch going with the inferior alveolar nerve into the mandibular foramen, so that's the inferior alveolar artery. It then courses back here, and then it's going to go into the caudal alar foramen. Okay, go through that alar canal and come out the rostral alar foramen. Now the maxillary nerve, which we see running with it here, it went in through the round foramen from the cranium into that alar canal and then came out with the maxillary artery through that rostral alar foramen. Okay, we can see here some branches coming off here. This is going to be the external ophthalmic artery, getting off these branches. And then we're going to continue rostrally here. And as we come rostrally, we will give off the minor palatine artery, which is going to go down and do the soft palate. And then we come along here and we're going to branch. The more dorsal branch here is going to be the infraorbital artery, which will come out here through the infraorbital foramen. And this larger branch here is the descending palatine. Now that descending palatine is going to branch into the sphenopalatine artery, which will go through the sphenopalatine foramen, and the major palatine artery, which then goes through the caudal palatine foramen. Okay? Then we will see branches of that major palatine artery coming out through our major and minor palatine foramina to supply the hard palate. Now, something to remember about the circulation to the cat brain is it does not have an extracranial internal carotid artery that goes to the brain like we see in the dog, but it has a complex up in here called the radii mariobilis, which sends branches into the brain. And the maxillary artery is going to pass up through here on its way. And in that course, you have to be careful, because if you do dentals and you crank this jaw open too far, it's going to compromise the blood flow by pinching off that maxillary artery. And so we can end up with sight problems, other signs that look like a stroke, because of lack of blood to the brain. Okay, so in the feline, that maxillary artery is going to provide a primary blood supply to the cranium. And so by cranking this jaw up like here, this angular process can pinch off that maxillary artery. So we don't want that. Not a good idea. We see then here the maxillary nerve coming through. Maxillary nerve is going to branch here. We've got this small branch here, pterygopalatine nerve, which will then give rise to a minor palatine nerve, which follows that minor palatine artery to the soft palate. And then, just like the descending palatine artery, pterygopalatine nerve is going to branch and give rise to the caudal nasal nerve that goes through the sphenopalatine foramen. And the major palatine nerve, which goes through the caudal palatine foramen. Okay. The infraorbital is going to continue through the infraorbital canal. It's going to give off some superior alveolar branches to the upper teeth. It's also going to then come through the infraorbital foramen to supply sensory from the face. So if we look just deep to the maxillary nerve here, we see this ganglia. This is the pterygopalatine ganglia. Has nothing to do with the maxillary nerve, but this has to do with the facial nerve. So the pterygopalatine ganglia is the parasympathetic that's going to be responsible for the lacrimal gland and much of the glands within the oral and nasal cavity. The mandibular and sublingual salivary glands, and the glossopharyngeal gets the parotid salivary gland. We look here at the ocular nerves. This great big one here is the optic nerve, so that's sensory from the eye. And we can see just here, more ventral to it, is the oculomotor nerve. And the oculomotor nerve has a ciliary ganglia. Okay, so cranial nerves 3, 7, 9, and 10 have parasympathetic. Okay. So this is going to be parasympathetic to the ciliary muscles as well as to the dilator pupillae muscles. Okay. Now we can't see the trochlear nerve going into the dorsal oblique muscle, but we can if we come over here to the lateral rectus. We can see entering right in here is going to be a branch from the abducens. Remember, the abducens does the lateral rectus and the retractor bulbi muscles. Let's see what we have back here. So here we can see our common carotid artery. Running with it, our vagosympathetic trunk. Right here, our sympathetic portion separates. So we just have the vagus nerve here, and the dilation of the vagus nerve here is going to be the nodosal ganglia, which is basically the nerve cell bodies of the sensory portion of the vagus. Then we have here the cranial cervical ganglia, which is the sympathetic portion. And this is the last place that these sympathetic nerves can synapse before going off to structures in the head. We see coming off the vagus right here a nerve, which is going to come down and pass rostral to the
thyropharyngeus
muscle, and that's going to be the cranial laryngeal nerve. It's going to innervate the cricothyroideus as well as sensory from the mucosa of the larynx. We see here just lateral to that cranial cervical ganglia, we see the glossopharyngeal nerve. And the glossopharyngeal with the vagus is going to create a plexus of nerves here that are going to innervate the pharyngeal region, both muscular as well as sensory. Glossopharyngeal
also responsible for taste from the caudal third of the tongue.
And then back here, we have a branch coming out here, going caudally. This is going to be the accessory nerve. Remember, it's going to come back and do the muscles of the neck and shoulder. That's cranial nerve 11. And then this guy here, if we follow him around, and if we come around here, we see that nerve coursing with the lingual artery. This is the hypoglossal nerve. And remember, hypoglossal is going to do hypo, below, tongue structures, so it's basically going to do the innervation to the muscles of the tongue. So that's the hypoglossal or cranial nerve
12.